Hello everybody, my name's Mark Wild. I'm the CEO of HS2 Ltd. We're building Britain's new high-speed railway from London to the West Midlands. Currently at peak production, 34,000 colleagues working on this immense, unprecedented project. A lot's happened since my last update. We've achieved the completion of the Bromford tunnels in the West Midlands, 3.5 miles of tunneling that completes all tunneling work between Old Oak Common and Curzon Street, a total of 45 miles of tunneling. Really pleased to see that activity completed. 10 of the 12 tunneling drives are now done on HS2. It's also not just the tunneling. Dozens of bridges and viaducts have been worked on. Of particular note was the Lawley Middleway bridge push. Exceptional work, particularly on that viaduct. No disruption to the road users, superb job done by the teams, and very, very typical of all the work going on across the programme. And of course, milestones to come in the future. We are completing the Curzon 2 bridge. You'll see it on the train as you pull into Birmingham. We're changing the skyline of Birmingham, and that bridge will be completed in the coming months. Of course, despite all of the great achievements of production, in this year on HS2, we're not where we thought we would be or where we'd planned to be. When we started this project at the notice to proceed in April 2020, by now we had intended to have completed the civil engineering and also be well on with this project, well over half complete we should be in terms of the whole system. Because of course we're not just building a civil engineering project, we're building a railway which is a complete system. It includes the track, the overhead line, the electrical engineering, the train, the depots, the silings. All of these things come together in a singular system. And we're behind. And that's why we're resetting the program to get everything back into the right sequence. Several external reasons, of course, about why HS2's program has fallen out of sequence. But I found three enduring problems that we will fix in the reset. Firstly, we've started construction before design has been complete. Secondly, we have contracts with our supply chain partners that don't encourage good performance. And thirdly, HS2 Ltd was really not set up to deliver the whole system. Now, these three enduring problems will be addressed in the reset. So what's the reset all about? It's about putting all of the activities for the whole system back into the right order. How do we do that? Well, we go to the end of the project and we work backwards. That's important because the day this railway opens, it has to be safe, reliable for the customers that get on the trains and the operators who operate the system. We've spent the past year working out in great detail all of the dependencies between the building blocks of HS2, working out the sequence of the work. Of course, we have to deliver this job for the lowest reasonable cost in the fastest time, but we have to have 2 feet in reality to do the sequence in the correct way. We found in Crossrail that if the civil engineering became overlapping with the electrical engineering, with the testing, we really had problems with productivity. The best way to get this job done is to do the building blocks in the correct order, complete the civil engineering, give access to the track and the overhead line, then do the electrical engineering, then bring the systems on board, and finally, of course, bring the whole system together in testing and provide enough time for operational proving at the end. This is what we did in Crossrail and it's what we're doing right now. That process is well advanced. I look forward to sharing more of that in the future with you, but you can be assured this reset is the reset that will hold to the end of the job, and we will break the cycle of continual cost increases and delays that obviously undermine confidence. While we reset, it's important we keep productivity up on site. 34,000 brilliant colleagues working on this program from 3,500 UK companies. One of the biggest engineering projects ever undertaken in this country, unprecedented in its size and scale. And I'm really proud of the teams working so hard out there, making every pound count while we reset. Of course, safety is intrinsic in that. We have a belief and an ethos here of zero harm, nobody getting hurt on this program. I'm really pleased about our safety performance, but of course, we've got to continually work on that. And we all know that good safety will lead us to good productivity and lead us to the opening of the railway. Okay, everybody, more in the future, but hopefully that's given you a flavor of how we're resetting and while at the same time we're maintaining productivity on site. Thank you very much.